Nigel Kiernan, 141-57861. This is my project. So it's first term, third year. It's a portable mirror, and it can be placed in a bedside locker or table. It is adjustable, so if you can imagine, that's the sleeve, so it's adjustable along the sleeve, and then your mirror can adjust like that. It's portable, so it can be placed in many locations around the house. Here's if we move on there. And why I designed this project, so it's first term, third year. As I stated in my term analysis, it's just before the brief comes out for the junior third project. So I wanted to give them an element of design and practice room for the junior third. So it kind of incorporates a lot of processing and basically just gives them a practice room for their junior third project. So I also wanted to have control of my project. So that's why I will provide a working drawing for some parts, and it assesses most knowledge and skills developed over the last 2 years. So from first year and second year, there's a lot of sawing techniques, so sawing parallel to the grain and sawing perpendicular to the grain, and then sawing at angles as well, and then the stretching involved in my project as well. So it will cover all that area as well. It is for first term or third year, so it'll be just after the students come back after the summer. So it's kind of, I felt it was a good project to get them settled down, get them interested in, and to kind of, you know, some summarizes the what they have done over the last 2 years. If you move on there, so first of all, I give them the project. Provide them with a picture like that and get them thinking. So this kind of focus on the technology capability. So they have to draw the plan and the elevation and the side view, kind of get them an understanding of the project. And then I provide them with the work and drawing, and they have to work out how the width and the height of the mark. So, like I said, a brief will be given to the students. The work and drawing will also be given. And then this is just the processes here. So the different processes that would be. So first of all, it'll be the marking out. Then it will be the dovetail, and the dovetail piece will be processed. I'll also give them the demo on the dovetail, because they might not have done a dovetail joint before. The two base pieces will be then processed. So these two base pieces here, so there's cope and saw, and there's spoke shaving involved in them. And then the mortise machine will also be used to give them a demo on that, just to recap. And there'll be also pairing then, and then assembly finish and self-evaluation. So I will also be providing formative feedback and assessment throughout the project. Then down here, it's just the kind of the design aspect. Students would go off and, you know, find out the width of a bedside mirror, or the most appropriate width and height, and what's the most appropriate angle for viewing yourself, because everyone's not the same height as shown in that picture. And then I also will use the analogy of a book stand to explain how everyone's not the same height, and then the perpendicular to the line of sight when viewing yourself. So how I teach my project and what's important about it, you know, it covers literacy skills, numeracy skills, as you can bring in math problems to it, so you can use your sine over is equal to opposite over hypotenuse. And then the project, it has a pedagogical approach, as students are combining skills like problem solving with numeracy and literacy skills. And then I'll just clarify why I made the project at an angle. So when it's wall mounted like this, it's not adjustable. And then you can look at joints as well. So the dovetail joint, why it is a strong joint and why it is suitable compared to like a mortise and tenon there. I will use my analogy of when explaining about the dovetail, so cutting. and I will explain stance and relate that to a pool pair stance here. And then I will also use the analogy of a boxer stance as well. Likewise, with when cutting a slice of bread, I'll explain how grip is important and how your wrist, shoulder, and elbow need to be aligned in to get a straight cut. And then, how does my project relate to technology capability? You know, students mess up with, say, the dovetail or the mic and get it right at the start. I let them mark that off another piece instead of having both of the pieces wrong. And or I might as well give them a practice run at a piece as well, just to get built up the skill. And then it relates to knowledge, skills, and values, as and the teacher can provide formative feedback as it goes along, and they get the opportunity to repeat this skill and make it better. That really sums up my project.